Good morning and welcome to the 26th meeting of the Net Zero Energy and Transport Committee for 2024. The first item is a declaration of interest, and I'd like to welcome our new member to the committee, Michael Matheson, who's replacing Ben McPherson. I'm sure actually everyone would like me to just put on record our thanks to Ben for all the work that he put into the committee. When I say he was extremely diligent in all he did, I don't mean that patronisingly. He was. He was painstaking in what he did, and he had a very constructive relationship with me. So I know he will remain a link with the committee because he's a substitute member. So I'm sure we'll see him again, and I look forward to that. So I think we all are pleased that that's the case as well. So I'm going to invite Michael Matheson to declare any relevant interest. Michael.
Good morning, can you hear me on? Thank you. The only item I would draw colleagues' attention to is that I hold an honorary fellowship from the Chartered Institute of Highways and Transportation.
Oh, okay. Thank you. So we can then move on to the second item on the agenda, which is the choice of a new deputy convener. The Parliament has agreed that only members of the SNP group may be deputy convener of this committee. So my question is, do I have a nomination? Jackie, you're not scowling at me, but you are waving your hand.
Thank you, convener. Yes, I'd like to nominate Michael Matheson as the deputy convener.
Okay. Jackie Dunbar has nominated Michael Matheson as the deputy convener. Are we all agreed? Yes, Monica.
Make a comment, if I will, and join you in welcoming Michael Matheson to the committee. I'm sure we'll all work well together. This is a point I want to put on the record. It's not a reflection on the nomination or the candidate for deputy convener, but it is a matter for the SNP and it's a matter for Parliament that the presiding officer commissioned a gender-sensitive audit, and I was part of that working group. And it's really important that when we're making decisions about appointments to Parliament that we bear that in mind and the aims of that audit and that piece of work. So for the second time that we've had a new deputy convener, we find ourselves with an all-male convenership of the committee, which is not in the spirit of what we're aspiring to. So it's a matter for the SNP today because they get to nominate. As I say, it's no reflection on Michael Matheson, but I think it's important that all business managers, you know, strive to get towards as much gender balance as possible. I don't know what Jackie Dunbar was saying across the table, but I just wanted to get that on the record. And I'm sure that all business managers read the official reports if they're not listening to our live proceedings. So thank you, convener.
Well, thank you, Monica, and thank you for reminding us of that work. But I think, bearing in mind what you've just said, I'm just going to ask the question I asked again, are we all agreed to appoint Michael Matheson as the committee's deputy convener? We are agreed. Thank you. Now, Michael, at the next break, I think you're going to move up the table to come and sit here. So the next item we have is consideration of whether to take items 4 and 6 in private. Item 4 is consideration of the committee's approach to the scrutiny of the current climate change bill. And item 6 is the consideration of the evidence that we've heard today. Do we agree to take these items in private? We are agreed. Then I will now move the meeting into private for item 4, and I expect us to be back in public session after a short while at probably just after 9 o'clock. So we now move into private session.